The White House says discussions are now underway for Vladimir Putin to come to the White House this fall for another summit meeting with President Trump. This comes despite the administration's ongoing efforts to clean up and clarify what happened earlier this week when Presidents Trump and Putin met in Helsinki. The U.S. Director of National Intelligence, Dan Coats, was visibly surprised when he learned about this second summit earlier in the afternoon while sitting for a live interview. Watch this.
We have some breaking news. The White House has announced on Twitter that Vladimir Putin is coming to the White House in the fall.
Say that again.
Vladimir Putin coming
to the... Did I hear you?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's going to be special.
Let's get some analysis from our political and legal experts. And Dan Abash, he's a very, very serious, very smart former senator, former U.S. ambassador to Germany, now the top spy in the United States. He doesn't know. How is that possible that the president of the United States is inviting Putin for a second summit in a couple months in the fall over at the White House?
Because the president he works for is Donald J. Trump. That's the reason. For the same reason that this president stood next to Vladimir Putin and threw that very director of national intelligence under the bus. He later cleaned it up, but it doesn't erase what happened and the visual and the unfortunate theater of that moment in Helsinki. He also, Dan Coats said, that he didn't know that that Sergey Lavrov was coming into the Oval Office at the beginning
at the beginning of the
administration.
The Russian foreign minister.
And a whole host of other things that he should have known. And by the way, Sergey Lavrov ended up leaking things from that meeting. You would think you would want your director of national intelligence to have a say in whether or not that would be a good idea.
And even more shocking, potentially, Crystal, is the fact that he said publicly in this interview that he doesn't know what happened at the first summit 3 days ago.
Yeah, it's kind of a six of one, half dozen the other in terms of trying to figure out which is the bigger news, because those are both huge news stories. The fact that the DNI doesn't know that the Russian president has been invited to the U.S. is big. The fact that he still has no readout of a summit that happened 3 days ago between the Russian president and the president of the United States, I actually think maybe a bigger deal in that what it suggests, they both suggest the same thing. There's a lack of communication, a total communication breakdown between the intelligence community as represented by Dan Coats and the White House. Is that surprising? No, particularly given Donald Trump runs the intelligence community down at every chance he gets.